Tolly Carr spent the last 116 days in the Forsyth County Jail. Tell us where he will physically go now that he has been sentenced.
He'll probably return to the Forsyth County Jail for a couple of days while they get the paperwork straightened out, and then he'll be sent off to either Central Prison or to Salisbury, which are both of the processing centers. There, they'll go through the intake, they'll get him processed, they'll determine what bed is most available for him. They'll try and give preference to the Forsyth County area. He could potentially end up back on Cherry Street.
And likely some kind of minimum security facility.
It would definitely be minimum security. There's no reason to keep him in one of the central prisons down in the center of the state.
And you've talked throughout the morning and afternoon about how extraordinary this case is in terms of its length and the kinds of things that we've seen in the courtroom.
Wanda, it's sad that what made him such a public figure has also probably added to the fact that he's got a substantial sentence here. There are little to no reason that the five mitigating factors were not balanced more strongly than the aggravating, other than the fact that he's a public figure. So I think the judge did send a message out there based on the public figure issue. And that's completely within the judge's discretion to do that. But given the five mitigating factors and only one aggravating factor, which was technically part of the charge itself, he should have been down in a mitigated range, and he very well qualified for a split sentence.
Talk a little bit about the message that was sent through all of this, particularly today's court proceeding, because you deal with DWI cases all the time, people who don't get the message. We heard from Tom Keith, we heard from Jim O'Neill, we heard from David Friedman and Locke Clifford, all saying that this should in some way send a message. Do you think it did, to tell people don't drink and drive?
That is an impossible question to answer, because there is no way to send a message to someone who has not planned to commit a crime. Your judgment slips when you have that first drink of alcohol. So people that normally are completely law-abiding lose their responsibility as they drink. So it's not a planned crime at all. It is clearly a crime, and our legislature has made it a crime and made it a felony even now. But it's impossible to send a message to somebody that doesn't think it applies to them.
Anything else you'd like to share with us?
It's very clear that public figures are held to a higher standard. That's part of the grace that goes with it. With it comes the responsibility that you're going to be held to a higher standard in sentencing as well. But that's part of the game.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us and offering your expertise and insights. Clarke Dummit, an attorney in Winston-Salem.